The Oslo Agreement was signed in 1993, after months of negotiations, most of them secret, since dealing with a terrorist organization was still a taboo inside Israel. As a preamble, there had been a declaration of principles, with a letter sent by Yasser Arafat to Yitzhak Rabin, the Prime Minister of Israel, and the Norwegian Foreign Minister, and in which he committed himself to renounce violence. The principle of Oslo was one of land for peace, and indeed, the autonomy of Gaza and Jericho were granted first in 1994. In 1995, after the signature of Oslo II, all Palestinian cities except Hebron were under Palestinian rule. Most Palestinians were by then ruled by the Palestinian Authority.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نبنيك يا فلسطين. نبنيك يا فلسطين. ترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة يقاتلون في سبيل الله فيقتلون ويقتلون وعدا عليه حق في التوراة والإنجيل والقرآن.
وشعبنا الفلسطيني لن يقف مقتول في الأيدي أمام هذا الانتهاك لمقدساته وأولى قبلاته، أولى القبلتين وثالث الحرمين الشريفين. وأنا بقول يا أخي سعد ويا أخي أبو جهاد يا إخواني الأبرار شهدائنا الأبرار، ناموا آمنين مطمئنين، فدماؤنا رخيصة في سبيل الهدف الذي جمعنا سويا والذي فرقنا لحظات، ولكننا سنلتقي قريبا إن شاء الله مع بعضنا البعض في عليين.
In 1997, after signing an agreement between Benjamin Netanyahu and Yasser Arafat, Israel redeploys its armies and leaves Hebron. Hebron, where the Jewish community were a millenary presence until pogrom in 1929, during which half of the Jewish population were exterminated by Arab nationalists. While this departure respecting the Oslo Agreement is another step taken by Israel towards peace, the Palestinian television shows different programs explaining what will be Palestine's definite borders and the role of the armed Israeli police force in virtue of the Oslo Agreement.
وسيكون لنا جيشنا. هذول اللابسين اخضر كلهم جيش، يزعلوا الجيران ولا ينبسطوا. هذول الجيش، جيشنا وفخرنا وعزتنا. هذه جيشنا.
Thousands of reservations about the Oslo Agreement. Indeed, from then on, the double language mechanism was to be intensified, while within the territories, a warrior organization was to be set up, punctuating attacks and nourished by the worst propaganda.
Every year, Yasser Arafat's Palestinian Authority holds military-style camps for the children. They're taught the history of Palestine in the morning and the tactics of insurgency in the afternoon. How to take cover, battlefield first aid, and slitting the throats of Israelis are all part of the curriculum. 10,000 children pass through these camps every summer. The youngest are 12. The authorities insist this is not part of a policy to prepare children for the front line, even if that is what it looks like.
معسكرات بأسماء الشهداء والمدن الفلسطينية يؤكد مدى الانتماء والإخلاص.
انت ايش بتستفيد من المعسكر؟
بنستفيد الادب والاخلاق، وبعدين تستفيد على تدريب نتدرب زينا زي الجيش، وبعدين بالمستقبل بنقدر نحمي الوطن اللي احنا عايشين فيه.
انت ايش تستفيد من المعسكر؟
برضو زيه، انا بحمي الوطن وبتدرب زي تدريب الجيش، وما حد مش حاجه بتنقصنا احنا والجيش زي بعض، فطور وتدريب وكله.
نحن نصنع تاريخنا. ما ننسهوش لا بالكلمة ولا بالصورة ولا بالكتاب، ولكن نصنعه بالحجر الفلسطيني.